Woolly mammoths are going to walk the earth again, and I am so excited! Fluffy elephants! Baby fluffy elephants! Squee! Hello and welcome back to Inform Overload. You have no idea how many times I almost accidentally call this channel Inform Overlord. It's basically like I say it every time. Inform Overlord. I really like the idea of being an overlord for informing. I feel like that maybe is the secret channel name that we're just not telling you. Anyway, I'm your host Rebecca Felgate covering the news for today. And if you've seen me before, then do say hi. But if you haven't, well, hi to you. Today I am talking about woolly mammoths. And if you can't tell, I'm actually really excited. I'm going to tell you all about them and some groundbreaking science, but before I do that, I want to ask you guys what your favourite animal is. Let me know in the comments section down below. Mine, if you can't guess, isn't actually elephants, but I do really like them. It is definitely dogs. Shout out to the best black Labrador in the world, Mr. Bracken, closely followed by Molly Burke's dog Gallop. He's cute too. Do let me know your favourite in the comments section down below, and while you're down there, leave a thumbs up to show us that you like our videos. Also, do check out the links to our Instagrams in the description box. Okay, woolly mammoths. So, woolly mammoths by and large died out around 10,000 years ago, although there were a few that lived up until 3,600 years ago. The civilized human race has no idea what living amongst woolly mammoths would be like. As global warming takes hold, we are finding more and more preserved animal carcasses under ice, especially in the melting permafrost regions of Siberia. For those of you who watch my other channel, Most Amazing Top 10, you will know that I love me some permafrost chat. It's all I ever talk about these days. In 2010, a 39,000-year-old carcass of a woolly mammoth was found in Siberia, Russia. Now, scientists called this young female Yuka. It's a common girl's name in Japan. Yuka was amazingly well preserved, and scientists were able to determine that she would have been between 6 to 11 years old at the time of her death, so not fully grown. In fact, Yuka was the best preserved mammoth in the history of paleontology. Researchers even found blood in her veins. This was amazing, and it led them to be hopeful that perhaps they could grab a strand of her DNA. So if this mammoth was found in 2010, why are we talking about it almost 10 years later? Well, as science and technology move on, it seems that we may actually be able to use Yuka to bring back woolly mammoths. Studies are being carried out by Kindai University in Osaka, Japan, along with a team in Russia, who are working on something called somatic cell nuclear transfer. This is cutting-edge cloning technology, and it is only getting better. Scientists famously cloned a sheep and generated Dolly, the first cloned mammal from an adult somatic cell. Now, this was also done via nuclear transfer too, but this was 20 years ago. Dolly was generated in Scotland in 1996 and died in 2003, so not quite enjoying the normal 10 to 12 years of life that you would expect from a sheep. If Yuka the woolly mammoth is cloned, then it would be the biggest cloning achievement to date. Also, quite literally, as woolly mammoths are pretty big. They grow between 11 and 15 feet in height, so that's up to 4.5 meters high. I'm pretty short, but like, wow. That is pretty massive, although it is quite comparable to modern day African elephants. But once again, fluffy elephants. While we possibly could bring woolly mammoths back, should we? That's the question. In their day, woolly mammoths lived in the Arctic and died out when they were overhunted by humans and badly adapted to their changing environment. If we did bring them back, there's no saying that they would survive. Earth conditions today are very different than those that they were living in 10,000 years ago. Our air has changed, and they may be susceptible to modern disease, and, as we mentioned, the permafrost is melting, so it might not actually be cold enough for them anyway. Wouldn't it be a bad thing to bring them back if they had absolutely no chance of survival? Well, I suppose that those are the ethical questions that people are expecting scientists to answer. It plays into the age-old debate of just because scientists can do something, does it mean that they should? I personally am so pro-science and really pro-innovation and experimentation for the betterment of society, but I wouldn't want them to bring something back just to let it suffer. What do you think, guys? Do let me know your thoughts in the comments section down below. I honestly think that this is a super interesting discussion. Also, I have to ask, where does it end? If scientists bring back the woolly mammoth, what will be next? Will humans one day bring something back, like an apex predator, like the Titanoboa snake? It's a huge snake, and then, like, are we gonna be sorry? Are we gonna wish that we hadn't? This is all very fantastic beasts, isn't it? But what if this was our life? Again, please do share your thoughts in the comments section down below. Okay, so that is all I have on this story. As of yet, we don't have a time frame on the return of the woolly mammoth, but we know it is in the pipeline, which is pretty cool. Okay, before I go, I want to read some of your comments from a previous video because we love everything you have to say. You are beautiful potatoes, and we love reading your thoughts. So I'm gonna do it. Charlotte did a video yesterday about a man swallowed by a whale, which is pretty biblical, isn't it? Luckily, the diver did survive, but how incredible is that story in that footage? Puppy Gaming said, "What a pleasant story. I love the pleasant news stories IO tells." Honestly, we're glad that we can tell you some pleasant ones. It's a mixed bag with news, isn't it? Ashley Lopez said, "The whale was probably like, this is way too small and I need a bigger snack," and then just left him alone. True, true. Charlotte is the kind of person to go and try this for herself. Well, guys, if you were wondering where she was today, I mean, maybe she's living in a whale now. Just joking, she'll be back later. Probably, anyway. Okay, that is all we have time for, so please do once again leave your comments on woolly mammoths, get in the woolly mammoth chat, I can't think of any better chat, and do let me know your favourite animal. Once again, if you're watching this video, please do like it, share it with a friend, and stick around for more daily news. I'm your host, Rebecca Folgate, and I'll see you soon. Bye!